Gush followers, this is your girl Remy, and right now you're tuned in to Gush News Network for the week of December 15th. Right now I have with me in the office is Mr. Marcus Jones, aka Mr. Shytime Biz, straight out of Chicago. How you doing, Mr. Biz?
I am doing absolutely wonderful. Excuse my voice, I just came back from the baddest grudge race of 2015, and as you can see, I am hoarse.
Well, I still want to thank you for coming into the office. I know you did your thing out there as well, but I want to know if you have the time to answer a few questions for our grudge followers.
Yes, I do.
All right, Mr. Ben. So, I was told that you're in a new combination and you have a new team. Is that correct?
Semi-correct. I'm still with my Midwest brothers, which is Set on Kill Racing out of the great city of Harvey, Illinois, aka Chicago. I'm still with Set on Kill, never left Set on Kill, but I am teamed up down here in the South with Team Taliban. Big Dave, he's the crew chief. We got Junebug. We have Chick Peters, and we have the freak, Brian Watts, who actually pilots my vehicle.
All right. So he cleared that up for us. I know we all had a few questions about that. So another question we would like to know is, what's that record looking like between the wins and the losses? Tell the followers what the wins and the losses is looking like.
The wins are... knocked off a couple of big blocks in the beginning over in Jackson, South Carolina. Lost to Willie Dog, the Godfather. And we didn't fare too well down in Orlando. We raced Spazoff out of Indiana, lost that race, and then got paid a punk out from Lil Will out of Detroit. And we also lost a hard race with Puerto Rico Pete, which is out of Chicago. It was a great race. It was fun to see. It was the talk of the actual weekend, how the freak drove that car. It was unbelievable. And that's why I'm hoarse today.
Okay, Mr. Biz. So, as you mentioned, that you were out in Orlando at Baldy the Lizard at the Speed World Raceway this past weekend. It was a pleasure meeting you as well this weekend. I'm telling you guys, it was fantastic. And if you guys missed it, I'm going to have some footage for you guys. So you guys make sure you stay tuned in to Gush News Network for that. The turnout that went down in Orlando this past weekend. I want to know, who are a couple guys that you had races locked in with?
I had five races locked in. We locked in for Friday night, which is Spazoff out of Indiana. He was giving me the head up break to the eighth of mile, and we couldn't get that race off. It had got too late, too cold, and a whole lot of cars in the staging lanes. We just couldn't get that race off Friday night. Saturday we had Lil Will locked in at 2 o'clock. We had Boogeyman locked in at 3 o'clock. We had Puerto Rican Pete locked in before the track closed, and we also had Jacktown Hustler out of Detroit, Michigan. Jacktown Hustler, I guess, out of Jackson, Michigan. And that race was locked in for Saturday, but we couldn't get that one off Saturday because it was just so many people, so many cars, and a lot of wrecks, but spill downs, and we just couldn't get that last race off. So to answer your question, five races I had locked in for the weekend.
All right. So Cole Black did his thing out there on the tracks this past weekend, huh?
No. I see, I'm a winner, and I want to win, and I did not win. So Cole Black, it did what it's supposed to do. It was just untamable. You go back and look at the film, and Cole Black went on the bumper two times and broke the rear end, the first pass out. But she did what she had to do, man. We just gotta tame her down a little bit. Just like a dog in heat, you know, it's gotta be able to tame her, gotta neuter her. You know, we gotta cut them nuts off. Excuse my language, but we gotta get it. We gotta tame her down. But she'll be back. She'll be back.
All right. Well, I still want to give a shout out to Cole Black because he did his thing out there on the tracks this past weekend. One more question before we close. The followers want to know, what type of horsepower do it take to do a 300 feet stand?
Well, you know, it's a guy out there named Jamie Triggerman. He don't have enough horsepower to do what Marcotte did, you know. So I'm going to say if it was up to the Wizard, maybe about 300-400 horsepower. So I don't know, you know, but I got enough horsepower to do what I did. I just know Jamie, he don't have enough horsepower to do what I did. So I'm just going to leave it as a secret. I want to give a shout out to the Freak. I want to give a shout out to my Taliban crew for being behind me every step of the way. And of course, my Set on Kill crew who was giving me calls all through the night and giving me an encouragement while we was at the track. So we'll be back in 2015 stronger than ever. And we're coming up to Morocco June 6th, 2015, the invasion of Taliban, Team Taliban, the invasion of Team Taliban in Morocco. Team Taliban will be Set on Kill. All right, there we go.
All right, so I know you guys heard that. That was an earful. So I just want to thank Mr. Biz for coming out doing this interview with us. You guys stay tuned. We're going to have a lot more footage for you guys, especially from this past weekend where we're going to show where Cole Black did his thing out there. So I want to thank all of my Grudge followers for tuning in. Once again, I want to thank you, Mr. Chi-Town Biz, for dropping through and doing this interview with us.
My pleasure. My pleasure. It was my pleasure.
All right. And once again, this is your girl, Remy. You're tuned in to Grudge News Network, and we are out.